Hi guys, welcome to the first session of the ESP32 series. In this video, I will be demonstrating how simple it is to use Platform.io to develop and run simple IoT projects with ESPIDEA framework for the ESP32 board. So, before moving on, please subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss out any of our upcoming videos. So let's begin with the first chapter of this session, installing the Platform.io in VS Code. If you have already installed the Platform.io, feel free to skip this chapter. So in order to install the Platform.io, right, first we need to locate the package manager. So in the VS Code on your left hand side, you may find the activity bar. So in the activity bar, so this is the activity bar, and in this, this is the package manager, and in this search for Platform.io. Yeah, so this is the Platform.io. So this Platform.io is basically an extension. So this can be installed in VS Code, Atom, or any of any other editors. So I prefer VS Code. So let's install this. Yeah. So once the Platform.io is successfully installed, right, you will find the Platform.io ant icon on the left hand side activity bar. For those of you who are using the Platform.io for the first time, here is a small introduction on Platform.io. So first, let's open the official website of the Platform.io, platform.io.org. Yeah. So this is the official web page of the Platform.io, and the Platform.io is basically a next generation integrated development environment for IoT. So we can see here that this has a support for a very huge number of boards, around 1000 plus boards, and support for over 26 frameworks. So some of the most commonly used frameworks are Arduino, and then we have ESPIDF and FreeRTOS, and then we have this platforms. So it has around 48 platforms. So what are these platforms? So platforms, basically it comes with pre-built toolchains, debuggers, uploaders, and frameworks. So let's take a peek into the platform which we shall be using in our upcoming videos, which is Espressif 32. So if we just look into the packages, right, so we can see, yeah, it has many toolchains. It has Tool Ninja, Tool CMake, and few frameworks. So this Tool Ninja and Tool CMake, those are basically build tools. Okay, so those are used to build the application for the ESP32. And then we have this toolchain extensor 32. So these toolchains are basically are used to compile the code for the ESP32. And then this framework. So we have this, we shall be using the ESPIDEA framework, which is the official IoT development framework for the ESP32 board. So this framework basically consists of certain essential APIs for the ESP32 and certain scripts to operate this build chains. So this is about the Espressif 32. So let's go back. So now let's look into some of the features of the Platform.io. So as we can see here, so it has an integrated debugger, and it has unit testing, and the next feature which I like the most is static code analysis. So like as shown in this image, right, so it will just let us know how much memory was consumed, and what are the possible defects in our code. So using this, like we can find certain potential defects and we can fix those. So this feature I like the most in Platform.io. And finally, Platform.io also has remote development feature. So This is the end of this chapter, and the next chapter will be getting started with ESP IDF. Okay, so first let's install the Espressif 32 platform. So in order to install any of the platforms, right, so you could just click on this platform or your ant icon in this activity bar on the left hand side, and there you could see something called as platforms. So yeah, so here, right, there are two things. We have an embedded platform and we have an desktop platform. So since ours is an embedded platform, let's select the embedded tab on top and let's search for Espressif. Yeah, so we have this Espressif. So as we can see here, the latest version is 3.3, and maybe by the time you guys are watching this video, this version would have increased. Don't confuse this version with ESP IDF version. So this is the version of this platform, not the ESP IDF version. So if you go to the change log, right? Yeah. So as we can see here, so this is using the latest ESP IDF version, which is 4.3. Okay, and it was released 4 days ago. Yeah. So yeah. So don't confuse this platform version with ESP IDF version. So now let's install this. Yeah. So now we have successfully installed the Espressif 32 platform. So now let's head to the PIO home. So before actually starting with the Hello World project, let me give a quick intro on ESP IDF. So this is the official web page for the ESP IDF. So as per the web page, so this is the official IoT development framework for the ESP32 series. And as we see here, so ESP IDF is open source project. So ESP IDF is freely available on GitHub, and the interesting thing is that it's under Apache 2.0 license. So you guys can find a link to the official ESP IDF GitHub repo in the description. ESP IDF is production ready. So ESP IDF has a well-defined release process and a support policy. So each stable release undergoes a rigorous QA process that ensures production readiness. And then we have feature-rich software components. So ESP IDF supports a large number of software components such as RTOS, peripheral drivers, networking stack, etc. So I guess we have an image. Yeah. So as shown in this image, right, we have many software components such as network provisioning, OT upgrade library, network security, crypto library, and many more. Okay. So guys, stay tuned to our channel as we shall be explaining all the components mentioned here in detail in our upcoming videos in the ESP32 series. And then we have documents. Yeah. So this is one of the main key point of ESP IDF is that it has a very well written documentation. So guys, I have attached a link to the ESP IDF programming guide in the description as well. So this is the end of this chapter, and the next chapter will be Hello World project. So let's first open the PIO home, and in that we have to click on new project. So let me give the name of the project as ESP Series 1 Hello World. So so I am using NodeMCU 32S board. Select whichever ESP 32 board you guys are using, and then we have to select the framework as Espressif IoT development framework and not the Arduino. So let me just provide my custom path for the project. And once everything is done, click on finish. So once we click on finish, basically the PIO initializes the project for us. So it may take some time. So be patient and let the initialization complete. So now the platform.io has successfully initialized the project for us. So now the first thing what we're going to do is we're going to change the extension of the main file from .c to .cpp. The reason being, we shall be using the C++ for developing all our projects. So now once this is done, we need to add an extern block over here. So let me just paste it over here. Yeah. So actually there is a reason why we need this extern block over here. So now if we actually do not add this extern block, right, we may end up getting error something like this. So undefined reference to app main. So why do you think we're getting this error? So basically what happens is we know C++ supports method overloading and C does not. Okay. So what happens is, in order to distinguish between the various functions, so when the C++ compiler, it generates the object code, right? So what it does is it changes the names of those functions by adding certain information about the arguments. So this technique is called as name mangling. Okay, there is no standard way to do this and each compiler does in its own way. Okay, but C does not support method overloading. So the error which we saw earlier, it was like because the when we build the code, it was looking for the basically the ESP IDF was looking for the main method, okay, app underscore main, but it could not find it because that function name has been mangled and changed so to something else. Okay, so in order to solve this, what we do is we add this extern block. Okay, now what happens is, so whatever functions are defined in this block, the name, the function names are unmangled, are not mangled with, meaning mangling is not done here. Okay, so let me build this. So as we see here, the build was successful. Now let's add the ESP logging library. So hash include ESP log.h. So I will be explaining this library in detailed in our upcoming videos. Now when we log, right, there are two basic minimum arguments which are to be passed. One is tag and the other is the message. So now let's define the tag. Okay, so now we have defined the tag, and basically there are various log levels. So we have debug, we have error, we have information, verbose, and warn. So I will be using the debug level, and add the tag, and the message would be hello world. So I actually, if you see here, right, so I have defined the tag using const qualifier and not macros. So we could also use hash define tag and main. The reason why I'm not doing this is basically what happens is macros have limitation, so it does not have a scope. So because of which it can be accessible everywhere and it's a waste of memory. But this all the variables are defined using const qualifier have a scope. So it will be accessible only within that scope. Okay. So now let me build this. Yeah, the build was successful. So now since there are no errors, let's upload this code into our NodeMCU module. So we have this upload option over here. So let's select upload. So we'll expand this terminal. Okay, now the code was successfully uploaded. So now let's monitor and see whether Hello World is getting logged or not. Yeah, so we can see here, so Hello World is getting logged over here. But if you just plainly follow these steps, right, so you wouldn't see this Hello World getting logged over here. The reason being, we can see here that I have used the debug level, okay? But by default, when we create a project, right? So I will show you in the menu config. So here, right, we have something called as run menu config. So I will explain in detail about this menu config in the upcoming videos. So for now, let's open this menu config. Yeah, here we have to get inside the component config, and then we need to find something as log, yeah, log output. So we can see here the default verbosity is set to verbose. Okay, so the default log level is set to verbose. But this change was done by me. But by default, what happens is it will be an info level. So what happens is for all the logging statements of a verbosity higher than the one mentioned in this menu config will be removed by the preprocessor. So basically what happens is, right, so we have various log levels, okay? First is error, then we have warning, we have info, debug, and verbose. Verbose is the highest, okay? So what happens is, so for example, if I have defined the log level in the menu config as info, so all the log levels or log statements greater than this, which is debug and verbose, will be removed by the preprocessor. So this is what happens at the beginning. So what happens is when we first create the project, the default log level will be set to info. So make sure you change that from info to either verbose or debug. So I will choose verbose and then save it. So guys, this is the end of the first session of the ESP32 series, and I will be uploading new videos every week. So guys, do like, share, and subscribe to our channel.